down and continue with the investment.
This that's is large, Zimbabweans in the Volta region?
Yeah.
Farmers?
Yeah. Yeah.
Oh, I see.
Yeah. And they have about 20,000 hectares of land, and they want to go into very large scale production. You know, because of the situation in Zimbabwe, yeah. the nationalization of the land, they are looking elsewhere in Africa to invest, and they thought that Ghana was a place to look up to, and we have welcomed them so far. So it was a very unfortunate incident. It's the first time it's happening in the Volta region. People of the Volta region are very, very peaceful. So the president went there to commiserate with the Zimbabweans and the Queen Mother, who really was very pioneering in showing them the place and introducing them to North Tongue. So after that, he met with the chiefs and also took opportunity to look at other polling stations and to make another statement that everywhere he has been in the Volta region, it has been so peaceful. It can be peaceful everywhere in Ghana. There are only pockets of incidents which are turning out to be very negative. And it's because people just want to interfere with the process. Political actors are grandstanding and are being provocative and are flexing muscles, which is totally needless. This is just a registration exercise. You don't even know all those who you are marshalling to go and
whether
register,
they'll vote for you
whether they'll vote for you or not. So what is all this about? You know, so he made a very clear statement that let's keep it peaceful, let us allow the people to freely register. And on December 7, they choose who they want to vote for. And it's a similar thing he'll be doing in the central region tomorrow. I have heard people say the president appears unconcerned, he is not condemning. As commander-in-chief, as president, you don't go about just condemning anything. You will have to rely on investigative reports by the security. When it is clear who is at fault, who is guilty, then you can place your thumb on who to condemn. But what you do is to make sure that the security services are allowed to operate freely, is to make sure that you have resourced them, provided them with the environment, the logistics, the equipment, nobody is being victimized. And then you continue to make statements, you lead by example. You don't send out tags, you don't suppress anybody, and you let everybody know that, look, you are free to register, make sure that you are very democratic as a citizen, and a very responsible citizen at that, by wanting to be involved in the democratic processes of our country. So that's what presidents do. And I am impressed that the president has continued to stay on message since he was in opposition, coming into the presidency. He has not been belligerent. His posture has not been different. I would have thought that if there is any leader who maybe we can begin to take a second look at his pronouncement, which probably is leading to all what is going on, is the opposition leader. This business about win at all costs, all die be die, that is what is triggering these things. And so his followers think that, look, as Abu was saying,
well, his followers think that they've been beaten up.
Yeah, they should die for a cause. They want to, you know, set up some Arab revolution. I mean, over what? A registration exercise? And all this provocation all over the place. People tie their heads with bandage and they listen to what they were saying when they got there. Where is Nilante? Where are you? Come out. Is that democracy? What do they want to do to Nilante when they see him?
They believe that he orchestrated the violence against them the day before.
So is this how to address it? Even if what they are saying is true, that Nilante has orchestrated violence against them, what happened to law enforcement agencies? What happened to our courts? What happened to legal processes? So you lead your supporters. Then if the other supporters did not restrain themselves and they also want to show you that, yes, we are not cowards, bring it on. Let's have a clash. Then what happens? So I think that we need to rise above this kind of politics. It's too low. It's so gutter. We cannot continue this way. It's so unsustainable.
The politics of violence,
the politics of agent provocateurism, where, you know, people just want to provoke you, you know, unwarranted.
But you are talking about the president, honorable minister.
It really
but
doesn't help.
The president is not the only political actor of your party. There are other actors who have been equally provocative.
I'm speaking in general terms, regardless of which political party you belong to, because I'm making the point that we don't need all these provocations. This is just a registration exercise. All these people you are marshalling and you are insisting they should register at all costs, you don't even know how they will vote on December 7th. They might be for you today. By December 6th, they will change their mind. They would have a second view of the political situation and decide to change the direction they vote. So there is really no need to be engaged in all of this. People violating all our electoral laws, they will not stay within parameters. They will leave their constituency and want to show that they are, you know, of a superior might and force. And so they are going to assist others in their constituency. I mean, it's so provocative that you wonder what's going on. This is not our country. This is not a Ghanaian nature. We shouldn't encourage this. And I think that all of us should just, you know, beat our swords into plowshares. Let's avoid all these, you know, increasing of stakes and increasing tensions. I don't know what we benefit from it. I mean, after this registration, there's a long way to go. There's more than 7 months of campaigning. None of the parties have finished with their manifestos yet. We have not yet produced the blueprint on where we are moving this country in the next 4 years. We haven't even finished our surveys, how the Ghanaian is thinking, what their the new middle class, the new people who, the first-time voters, what will be their considerations and all of that. A very, very serious analysis that we have to be making at this point in time. That one will think that, you know, the parties will focus attention on that, focus attention on the issues. But what do we see? I mean, everybody wants to become Rambo, wants to become Schwarzenegger, wants to show that they have muscles, they can bring it on. I mean, really, how is that going to solve poverty? How is it going to address our challenges confronting us as a country? How is that going to move us into a stronger middle-income status than we are now? Really, this kind of politics is so backward, it's so uninspiring, and I mean, we all have to condemn it.
I think we have to do the Green Book another time, Honourable Minister. I see that you became very passionate about what is happening. You're very interested about it. And we hope that in your own area, the news will come in a way that we know that you are not showing machoism and brandishing strength and authority of a ruling party. So you would like us to believe that when the president says that he is for peace, that he's actually for peace?
Actually for peace. He can't.
The MPP think that time and again, his statements do not coincide. They don't converge with the activities of the NDC people, and he doesn't condemn it.
That cannot be true. The last rally, the president addressing his own people said that, look, let us focus on our achievements. Let's stop the politics of insults. There's more to say about what we have done on the ground that will win us more votes. He was speaking to his party faithful there. He spoke directly to them. I don't know what else they expect from the president. This is not the kind of president who just engages in, you know, just public show. But he would do the right things, say the right things at the right time. Mm. The people who criticize him, who say that they expect him to be of a different posture, don't see anything wrong with the posture of their candidate. When he says we must win at all costs, when he says all that be that, don't you think that those are precipitating statements for what we are seeing today? The kind of posture, the things we are seeing as we speak. We have lost a party agent in the Brongahafu region.
He died?
Stabbed to death, yes.
NDC party agent?
NDC party agent.
Yeah, Abu made the point, yes. Of a person that died.
Yeah, yeah. You know.
Stabbed to death?
Yes, stabbed to death.
About registration?
About registration. You know, we've lost one important life. If you put the vote aside, life is more precious. Nobody knows who he will have turned out to be. Why does it have to be that way? A former regional minister was manhandled, dragged on the floor. He's now petitioning all over the place. You know, it's you're wondering what's going on. And I think that statements like that, belligerent statements, I mean, very provocative posture, are not helpful. So let us rededicate ourselves to democracy. If we say we are really, I mean, Democrats and we believe in the rule of law, let's follow the processes. If we feel that our rights have been violated, we have been attacked, what to do is not to lead whoever, whether they are supporters or thugs or hirelings, to a center to show muscle and to dare somebody to come out from his rat hole. I mean, so if he comes out, then what happens? What next? If there's a bloodbath, how does that help our democracy? How does it help our country? So we've got our methodologies wrong. We've got our posture wrong. And we can't continue this way. If it is about incidents of violence, I'm sure all of us can cite where instances where we have been victims. My boss, 2 weeks ago,
Fritz Bafo
had to lead the press to his campaign manager's vehicle, which had been totally burned down, totally
around Kolebu
in Dansuman. You know, totally burned down. The Okaikwe North chairman was beaten. There's a group of thugs who are calling themselves Wounded Lions, who
which constituency?
Okaikwe North and Okaikwe South.
Wounded Lions.
Yes, the constituency chairman there and constituency women's organizer have been hospitalized as we speak, and they say they are Wounded Lions of the MPP. You know, how will all of this help us? You know, so all of us can cite instances where we have been victims. Look at what has happened to our former regional minister. A lot of us feel that the police officer did not treat him fairly. But do we say that then we're going to attack the police service, or they should be lynched, as MPP stalwarts have said, or we will lead thugs into constituencies to show some strength? That is not the way to go. We can decide to sit down. We can decide to up our...
But you also worry when a woman like Esla is attacked by men. That's quite bizarre.
It's bizarre. Nobody should be attacked. It's totally unexplainable. We cannot accept it. Nobody must be attacked, more so a woman. No matter the circumstance. I've heard people say that she's very caustic and she attacks everybody, but still, I mean, if you feel defeat, there are legal processes. You can bring actions against her in the courts. You don't have to go violent.
I think we have to leave it here, Deputy Minister. We will find occasion next Tuesday to talk about the Green Book. Thank you very much for coming.
Thank you.
I'm sure that you're also tired from your Volta Regional Tour. We wish you the best in your constituency in North Tong.
Thank you, Paul.
And it's almost certain that you become an MP in December, because that is a very safe seat. The incumbent, how is he feeling about your victory?
Oh, we get along very well. He's a nice man. We were together with the president today. He's very optimistic that he's not finished yet in politics, and who knows, our constituency is still a very big constituency, and it might be split one day and he might make a comeback.
Okay, thank you very much, and regards to your lovely wife. I saw her at the Shinley Congress. I remember that.
Thank you, I'll tell her.
And thank you, viewers. Have a good weekend. Register peacefully, safely, and let's get ready to talk politics in a more matured and peaceful atmosphere. Bye-bye.